Good morning. Today my topic is histopathological techniques. I am Dr. Sheena Alphonse, Assistant Professor of Pathology, Sri Lakshmi Narayana Medical College in Puducherry. So coming to the introduction, histopathological techniques deal with the preparation of tissues for microscopic examination. Our aim is to observe the microscopic sections of tissue in a lifelike state. It involves a series of processes that includes fixation, dehydration, clearing, impregnation and embedding, cutting and then staining. So coming to the fixation, process by which tissues are fixed in a physical and partly chemical state, so that they will withstand subsequent treatment with minimal loss, distortion and decomposition. So the principle that occurs mainly is there is denaturation or precipitation of the proteins. So what are the features of an ideal fixative? It penetrates the tissue quickly, it is rapid in action, preserves tissue in a natural state, stabilize cellular components, avoid excessive hardening of tissues, and it allows enhanced staining. And these components should be cheap, stable, and safe. So these are the features of an ideal fixative. We come to the classification of fixatives. They can be aldehyde groups, wherein they cause cross-linking. They can be oxidizing agents, denaturing agents, physical agents and other agents and newer agents. So factors that affect fixation are the thickness of the tissue, duration of the fixation, temperature of the environment, pH of the fixative, osmolality, fixative itself and the concentration. So these are the factors that affect fixation. So labeling of tissues. Identification of the tissue should be allocated with a unique number. Usually it is a thin white card with writing in soft pencil. Sometimes it is written also along with a cassette where it is a permanent record. Automated generation, which can be helped with the use of computers and using of barcode. See, these are the various ways of labeling a tissue. Tissue processing, the aim is to embed tissue in a solid medium. It should be firm to support and give sufficient rigidity to enable thin sections to be cut. It should be soft enough not to damage the knife or the tissue. So ideally, paraffin wax, which is not miscible in water, fixatives should be water-based. So what is the definition? Treatment of the tissue to allow paraffin block embedding. This involves dehydration, clearing, impregnation and embedding. So factors that influence tissue processing is the agitation that is provided, heat, viscosity and vacuum. So dehydration, that is removal of the aqueous fixative fluid from tissue. So the principle is dehydrating fluids are hydrophilic. So they are used in increasing strength. So ethanol, when the tissue is exposed, it is exposed to increasing gradient of ethanol. So 70%, then 95%, then 100%. Volume of this fixative should be equal or more than 10 times the volume of the tissue. Ethanol, the advantage is it is miscible with water and many organic solvents. It is clear, colorless, but it is inflammable liquid. Other examples are industrial methylated spirit, methanol, propanol, isopropyl alcohol, acetone, diethylene dioxide or dioxane. So what are the additives that can be used to a dehydrating agent? Phenol, glycerol and hydrous copper sulfate. Clearing. What about clearing? It is dealcoholization. So clearing agents include hydrocarbon solvents that are miscible with a dehydrating agent and paraffin wax. Its refractive index is similar to the protein, which helps to give it that transparent appearance. Also remember, here the volume is equal or more than 10 times the volume of the tissue. So what are the criteria? It should have speedy removal of the dehydrating agent, easy to remove the paraffin wax, minimal tissue damage, should have less flammability, and should have less toxicity and lesser cost. So examples are xylene, which is excellent and a true clearing agent. Other examples are toluene, chloroform, oil of wintergreen, citrus fruit oil, and histoclear, which is a fruit grade material. So what is impregnation? Impregnation means it fills all the natural cavities, spaces, interstitium of tissue and within the cell constituents, and this is embedded with a paraffin block. This helps to cut the tissue into thin sections with the help of a microtome. So two methods are there: paraffin method, celadoin method, freezing method. And here you have to remember, volume should be equal or more than 25 times the volume of the tissue. So paraffin wax, this produced by the cracking of mineral oil. So remember that the melting point varies from 54 to 58 degrees Celsius, which is used for routine purposes. Additives that can help to increase the use of paraffin wax by increasing its hardness include beeswax, sericin, rubber. So what are the substitutes? You have paraplast and carbovax. They are more resilient and the ribbon sections come out easily. What are blocking out molds? These are nothing but metal or plastic molds that help us to get the shape of the paraffin block. So these include Leuchard's embedding iron, trays and cups of thin stout paper, tissue tech system, peel away system, tissue processing and embedding system, TIMS. So Leuchard's embedding iron is two L-shaped blocks of heavy brass, and they are used to even the blocks with parallel sides. They give rapid initial setting of wax, and the advantage is you can get wide variety of block size. Disadvantage includes it is cumbersome and slow. Tissue tech system, it is a white plastic cassette with detachable perforated stainless steel lids. So this has the advantage of increased tissue can be placed and filled with wax. So this is a picture of a tissue tech cover. What about tissue processing and embedding system? It consists of a perforated bottom, a frame centerpiece and a lid. All three snap together to form a capsule. So this is easier to use and very commonly used. What is the procedure? Mold is filled with a wax. Tissue is placed in the mold with the help of a heated forceps. It's oriented and then placed in over cold water or over refrigerator. So cooling lessens the tendency of some waxes to crystallize, gives a uniform, smooth and solid consistency to block. What about vacuum embedding? It is done under reduced pressure. It is used for lungs and tissue that contain air spaces and dense tissue like skin and embryo. What is an automated tissue processor? It is the complete system where there is a dehydration, clearing and impregnation. So there is a central rotating spindle that carries various baskets. So these baskets are electronically operated with a clockwork device. So when the tooth falls on the notch, the motor is activated and elevates the central spindle, which automatically rotates the bucket arm and it is swung to the next beaker. So this is a picture of an automated tissue processor. So two metal baskets contain molten wax at constant temperature. There is a short, repetitive up and down motion that gives you agitation. Time schedule depends on the thickness of the tissue, type of tissue, and the degree of urgency. So this is the typical 16-hour schedule that is started usually in the evening and it ends in the morning. So a rapid schedule can be done with a thermostatically controlled vacuum ultra model, which completes the whole process in 1 to 2 hours. The disadvantage is delicate tissues are distorted. Maintenance. This machine should be placed away from work area and should have adequate ventilation. Electrical supply is ensured by auto switch to a generator in case of a power failure in the night. All beakers should have the correct strength and the correct level. Any spillage should be immediately cleaned and plug should be always checked if it is having current. So coming to section cutting, so you have your microtome, water bath, dry oven or a hot plate, fine or curved forceps, a squirrel hairbrush, scalpel, slide racks, clean slides, eye tray and pencils. So these are the equipments that are there in the section cutting side. So what are microtomes? They are designed for preparation of minute sections of tissue. These include hand rocking, rotary sliding. So this is an example of a rotary microtome. So the important parts are, there's a flywheel, block holder, knife holder, a feed mechanism, micron scale and a locking mechanism. With each stroke, the block is moved few microns near the knife edge to give a thin section. So ribbon section comes out because of the heat and electrostatic forces. These are suitable for serial sections and used for routine blocks. It is not suitable for large paraffin sections. Whatever the quality of the knife, it should be very sharp and the edge should be free from blemishes. So steel blades have plano concave, biconcave, wedge and D profile. So the other types of blades include steel, other than steel, glass, diamond and tungsten. Modern blades that we use nowadays are disposable. So the length initially of these knives include 15 cm with a cutting edge and broad base. So two ends of a knife are present, heel and the toe. So the knife angle that are there is it's a wedge shaped knife with a wedge angle of 15 degrees, bevel angle ideal should be 27 to 32 degrees and the clearance angle is usually 5 to 10 degrees. Also you should know what is the rake angle. So what is a good cutting edge? Cut section of 2 to 3 microns of under a microscope at 100x, very fine discontinuous line, slightly varying in width. So what is a Von Mohs criterion? It is recommended that sharpening until the cutting facets come together to give a minimum reflection. So how to check is to cut hairs on the back of the hand against the own resistance. So this shows that this is a good cutting edge. Sharpening you can use by hand or machine or factory grinding. Hand sharpening, the example is the honing and stropping. So naturally occurring hones, they are nothing but stones with which you can use to sharpen the knife. The examples are Arkansas stone, yellow and green Belgium glass stone, Belgium black vein stone, and artificially produced include plate glass and carborundum stone. So the lubricants used are 3-in-1 oil or a soap or liquid paraffin solution. You can use abrasive powders. They are suspensions in water. So what is honing? It is to remove the gross nicks and cuts in knife cutting edge. The procedure is the knife with the knife back placed on the hone. Cutting edge should face away and heel is in the center. The knife is pushed forward diagonally from heel to toe, rotated on its back, and they do the figure of eight motion. So 20 to 30 strokes are sufficient to remove gross nicks. This is known as honing. So this is the figure of eight movement. What is dropping? It is to remove the fine nicks. Here we use leather, that is from the rump of a horse, and it is made of canvas. So two types are there, rigid and hanging. So stropping, it is necessary that between of each block that you do 1 to 2 times a day. So other method is the plate glass honing, where you use abrasive particles. Automated honing is also present. Water bath, what is this? This is a thermostatically controlled water heater that maintains the water at 45 degrees. Alternatives, you can use a section 1 to 2 drops of water placed in warm plate and water from a hot water tap. Dry oven, this is to increase the melting point of wax at drying it completely for 30 minutes. So usually you can use large ovens. So alternatives are hot plates, blower type electric slide dryer, and holding slide above Bunsen flame. Brush, needle and forceps, these are also important. Slides usually used are 75 into 25 millimeter, 1 to 1.2 millimeter thick. They are ground and polished edges. They have to be inscribed either by diamond pencil or soft pencil or automated labeling machines or barcodes. Section adhesives, these are nothing but to provide adequate adhesiveness of the tissue section to the slide. So sections tend to float when there is a strong alkali solution used in staining tissue from CNS or decalcified tissue. Sections submitted to high temperature and cryostat sections. So the examples are Mayer's egg albumin, gelatin, poly L lysine, and you have the 3-aminopropyl triethylsilane. So what about the microtome? First, you have to trim the block to a thickness of 15 microns and till the tissue embedding is exposed. For cutting the sections, after trimming, the section is placed in melting ice and tissue and block should have the same consistency. The tissue will absorb water, swell, and therefore section cutting will become easier. So the thickness is usually 3 to 4 microns. Block is then removed from ice, dried and clamped in the chuck of the microtome. The object holder is moved manually until the surface touches the knife. So for hard, you have to do firm and quick strokes. For soft, you have to do slow and gentle. Floating out the section. So trailing end makes contact with the water first and shining side down first. So 30 seconds, the sections are allowed to flatten. Flattening helps the wrinkled sections to improve. Prolonged floating in water, teasing with forceps, and judicious trimming of excess wax. These are the steps that occur in floating out of the sections. So after picking up this section on the slide, you have to immerse 3/4 of the slide vertically in water. So you have to drain the excess water by tilting 68 to 85 degree and then drying the section on the slide with still a small amount of water helps to further flatten the tissue when heat is applied. Temperature that should be maintained for drying is the melting point of wax. So sections, if there are faults, they include sections is scored vertically. That means the knife edge is damaged, it has a nick, or the knife is dirty and it needs cleaning. If the sections are curling up, the knife is blunt. Tilt of the knife is too great. Sections are alternatively thick or thin, then that means the microtome adjusting screws need tightening. Tissue is very hard and needs treatment with softening agent. Tilt of the knife may be too great. If the sections are crumbling, that means the knife is either blunt or there is wax which is too soft. Wax is crystallized due to slow cooling, or there is contaminant or water in the wax. So ribbon of the section is curved, that means the block edges are not parallel to each other. Block edges are not parallel to the knife also. If the breadth of the section is less than the block, it could be caused by compression of the block. This may be due to the loss of bevel on the knife, which needs to be honed to restore it. What about frozen sections? What is its use? It is the rapid production of sections for urgent diagnosis. Diagnostic and research enzyme histochemistry. It's used for immunofluorescence. Silver impregnation method in neuropathology. So when water is firm, frozen, water becomes ice and the tissue is given a firm consistency. So the ice embedding medium is used. So the block consistency varies. So unfixed, like non-fatty tissue, minus 25, and fixed tissue, 10 degree. So cryostat produces better quality, more quicker sections with fewer problems. Refrigerated cabinet is where the microtome is housed with the controls which are operated outside. So this is a frozen section. What we are seeing, a frozen cryostat, we are seeing an aerial view. So you can see the microtome is inside the cabin. So tissue should be well prepared. The block temperature correct for the tissue being cut, and microtome should be operated correctly. There is an anti-roll platelet plate adjustment which should be correct. So freezing temperatures that can be used are for liquid nitrogen minus 180 and CO2 gas minus 70. So these are done with for rapid freezing, and they can have ice crystal artifacts. So all diagnostic purposes, unfixed tissues are suitable. Disadvantages are these are liable to crack, overcooling for urgent biopsy blocks, can lead to freezing artifacts, and diffusion of labile substances. So the tissue can be fixed in cold formal calcium 4 degrees Celsius for 18 hours. So cryostat maintenance depends on each machine. Usually it is minus 15 to minus 23 degrees Celsius. The cryostat sections are cut in the microtome with the help of anti-roll plate equipment. Sections stick on the surface of the blade holder. Staining usually we do is rapid methylene blue, rapid HNE, and other methods. What about freeze drying tech? This is done with the help of quenching, drying, fixation and embedding, and subsequent treatment. What is a microwave? Microwave has a wavelength of 12.2 centimeter. And microwave cavity with a small window in the door, small visible lights are passed through. So it is produced by a magnetron and passed into a cavity and heats up the tissue. To even out the tissue heat, there is a rotation and more waves with the help of a wave stirrer. So the principle is oscillation, excitation of charged or polar particles lead to collision that increase the heat. So in fixation, this can be used for heating uniformly in a short time. So what are the uses? Microwave can be used at various levels, fixation processing, staining, antigel retrieval, and an IHC staining. So in fixation, tissue blocks can be very soft, can be microwave fixed and then cut. In staining, this helps to increase the decrease the staining time, but the disadvantage is it can have precipitates. What about processing? It can be used to speed up the diffusion process. It saves times and eliminates the use of xylene. Thank you.